Hey guys, it's MH Finn back with another video regarding options on Robinhood. This time we're talking about gamma. To get a good sense of gamma, you have to understand delta. So please make sure you check out my video on delta before you watch this. Now let's get started. Gamma, in its most simple definition, is the rate of change of an option's delta. It gives us a better understanding of how delta will change when the underlying asset moves. As an example, if we pretend we have a call option whose gamma is 0.25, delta 0.50, and the underlying stock goes up $1, the delta value should go up to 0.75 given all other variables stay constant. Let's take a look at a couple charts so we can further grasp this concept. It's important to understand the different labels before we begin. On the left-hand side, running down the y-axis, we represent the gamma value, which for us stretches from 0 to 0.25. On the bottom, running across the x-axis, we represent the stock price of the underlying asset. On the right-hand side, running down the x-axis, we represent delta as a value ranging from 0 to 1. And finally, represented by the blue arrow, we show the at-the-money price. This is the price at which the call option starts to have zero intrinsic value. This price is typically close to the break-even point. Now let's add the lines. The red line represents gamma values, which correlate to the values on the left y-axis, while the green represents the delta value, which correlates to the values on the right side of the y-axis. Gamma is the largest when the option is near the at-the-money price. This is easily shown on the graph as circled here. It gets smaller as the option is either deep in the money or out of the money. This is why our plot forms a half circle, reaching its peak on the at-the-money price, and then sloping down to zero when the stock price is either deep out of the money or deep in the money. Delta, on the other hand, forms a S-shaped curve. It gets bigger as the chances of profit increase. Delta is essentially the percentage chance an option will end up in the money. This makes sense as delta is low when the stock price is low, indicating you will need a miracle for your call option to profit because the underlying stock would have to move significantly up to reach the in-the-money price. Delta is high as we move closer to $30, as the call option is deep in the money, representing a very good chance that the option will end up in the money. The relationship that exists between the two is further explained later in the video, but it is very important to note that gamma is typically at its highest when the price of the option is exactly at the money, and that gamma decreases approaching zero as the call option gets deeper in the money or out of the money, or as delta approaches zero and delta approaches 1, whichever way you want to say it. That was a chart showing a call option. When buying a short option, the same chart is essentially inversed. In a short option, you are looking for the price of a stock to fall below a certain point. This means that the delta approaches negative 1 as the price of the underlying stock price gets higher and approaches 0 as the price of the stock gets lower. Remembering that the values are all negative, this makes sense, showcasing that your chances of profit are the best when the underlying asset is low. Gamma on the short side remains the same, but the circle is essentially inverted because values on this side are of course negative. It helps to think about gamma in a physics sense. We can say gamma is acceleration if delta is speed. A lot of experts like to describe gamma as the stability of an option's profitability, and I agree. If you can sit back and think about that, you can begin to grasp its effect on options pricing. If one option has a delta of 0.75 and a low gamma, that option in theory has a better chance of profit than an option with the same delta but higher gamma. Gamma plays on delta in order to correct for something called convexity of value. Explaining that would take a PhD math professor and an entire semester, but you really don't need to understand the specifics if you just want to have a general overview. This phenomenon works in favor of those buying long call and short options. Decelerating losses for every $1 an underlying asset moves against you, and accelerating profits for every $1 it moves in your favor. Next time you're buying an option, pay close attention to its gamma number. You will begin to notice and understand its differences, and if you are at the stage where you are beginning to write and sell options, be wary of its dangers. Gamma is highly complex, but if you can begin to understand its effect on delta, you will begin to form the picture that is options pricing. I hope my video helped you understand. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. The feedback I've been receiving from you guys has been amazing, and I look forward to creating many more videos. Thank you.